Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Nate with The King of Random, and today we're going to make a fun device that makes bubble foam balloons that float into the air. Similar devices are used to make floating foam shapes that serve as advertisements, but I really just think that they are fun to make and play with. The purpose of today's video is to find an easy way to make this machine that can produce these foam flying balloons. Here's the materials we're going to need for this project. A flat pan. I find that straight-walled pans work better than pie tins. This was less than a dollar at Walmart. Some thin vinyl tubing. I got this stuff for 15 cents per foot, and about 6 feet is plenty. A tank of helium, which you can get at Walmart or most party stores for around 30 bucks. Bubble soap, a glue gun and some extra glue sticks, a lighter or torch, and a couple of pins. Now that we have all of our parts and tools, let's get started. First, let's use our glue gun and use a little bit of hot glue to plug up one end of our vinyl tube. Now we've glued up the end of our tube, let's glue it to the center of our cake pan. Add some extra glue going over the top of the tube to help secure it permanently in place. In a spiral, let's move out from the middle, gluing down the tube all the way. Using extra glue, secure the tube near the edge and at least one more spot in the middle of the coil. Okay guys, now that we've got our tube glued down in a spiral on the bottom of our pan, let's add some small holes to make our bubbles. First, let's take our straight pin and heat the tip up using our lighter. Then we'll use the hot tip of the pin to poke holes in our vinyl tubing. Do this about every 3/4 inches along the tube. Okay, we've taken our tube and we've filled it with a lot of tiny holes, and now we want to test that all of those holes work. Otherwise, we're going to get some lopsided foam balloons as the air comes out of one side but not the other. The easiest way to test if the holes are working is to fill your mouth with water and then blow the water down through the tube. It will create a tiny fountain from every hole in the tube, and you'll be able to see which ones may have become plugged back up. If you see any without a jet of water coming out of them, you need to heat your pin back up and melt a new hole. All of the holes in our tube seem to be working well, which means our foam bubbler is complete, and it's time to start adding bubble soap and making foam. We actually don't want to use pure bubble soap. It's a little bit of a heavier liquid, and so even with helium in it, it's heavy enough that it won't float very well. So what we actually want is about 1 part bubble soap and 7 parts water. Gently stir the bubble soap in the water to get a nice even mixture. We want to make sure there's enough bubble solution to cover the vinyl tubing, but we don't want it to fill the pan. There should be some exposed edge still.
Now, we need some helium.
The vinyl tube should fit snugly over the nozzle that comes attached to the helium tank. Just like that, our foam bubbler is complete. Now let's take this outside and make some floating foam balloons. At this point, we just undo the stopper on the tank, press down on the valve, and helium will start forming bubbles in our pan.
There it is. Oh.
I do find we get better and more consistent results if we grow the bubbles out slowly instead of opening the valve as far as it will go. I think by going slowly, it allows time for the excess bubble fluid to drain off of the foam that's forming so it doesn't weigh it down. Oh, oh, broke free. There we go. Now, because all of the bubbles are full of helium, as the tower grows, it just sort of keeps itself straight up. This lets you grow the tower taller and taller until too many bubbles pop or it has enough lift that it pulls itself right off.
Oh, you can still see the last one.
Wind. Wind has liberated the bubbles. Okay, I added more bubble solution into the pan, so there's more of it covering up the vinyl tubes. And what appears to happen is that I have a lot smaller bubbles now. I'm not 100% sure if that's gonna be a good thing or a bad thing yet. I'm liking the look of this.
Trying to float, that's a plus.
There it goes. There it goes, it's like a big white caterpillar going up and, oh, the tree caught it. I'm gonna try and free it. Let go, let go, let go. I think it lives there now. Sticking to my hand, but I think I'm gonna shake it off and then it's gonna take off into the air. There it goes. The wind has completely changed direction, apparently. Be free, little cloud! Bubble balloon. Quah! There it goes, there it goes. Launching off into the sky. That looks like a giant flavorless Cheeto. Oh, it's cruising. I'm gonna try making some smaller ones. Sometimes right after you take it off, it's still kind of dripping extra bubble soap. So if you just give it a second, it'll start pulling more and more. This one's a little heavy. Oh, there you go. You can see as it starts dripping off some of the excess, it will gain a little bit more altitude. It's alive! It does kind of look alive, like it's just moving in the wind and it's just like a weird tentacle growing out of the cake pan. Tentacle cake. It's a new kind of cake. Oh, wind. Ha! It's stuck in the trees and power lines right there. It's just bubble soap. Can you imagine how confused you would be if something like that just sort of like drifted into your yard? You'd have no idea what that was. That'd be kind of weird. I'm gonna see what happens if I just push on the valve as far as it'll go and give it like full power helium. All right, that was a little anticlimactic. I wonder if our helium's running low. Go, 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 go! Guys, this was great. It was so cool to just watch those foam balloons launching up into the sky. This is a quick and easy build that you can do at home, and it's a ton of fun to play with. I've got some crazy ideas about how to scale this up in the future, including I want to try making a bubble pan that's several feet across. A couple other things I want to try are this helium that comes for filling balloons is actually not pure grade helium. It's helium mixed with about 20% air, so I think we might get some better lift if we use some industrial strength helium. And then of course, I also want to try using hydrogen so we can make some foam balloons that will light on fire when you hit them with a flame. There you have it. Now you know how to make your very own foam balloon machine. Thank you for joining us for this project today, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then. There's no wind in here. It's great. Just keep going. No, don't get stuck in the other tree. Be free. Be free. Yes. No. Bubble hands. Bubble hands. This audio should be in the video somewhere. Let's see if I can get it to touch the ceiling. If I have enough helium for that. You can do it, little foam tower. You can do it. Grow. Since it's like soap, do you think it will clean the ceiling off a little bit? Go, go, go. You're so close. Like an inch away. We've done it. We've done it. We are touching the ceiling. What?
Hey guys, I have seen your comments begging me to come back into the videos, and although I can't do that right now, I really do appreciate how much you care. Even though you can't see me, I'm still very much a part of this channel and a part of these videos, and I still love you just as much.